We're just days away before a law which would mandate bathroom signs about transgender use is set to take effect in Tennessee. Now, a few business owners like Bob Bernstein, owner of Bongo Java and Fido in Nashville, are taking action.
When the bill was first passed, I kind of got angry and wondered what to do and how we can make a statement.
Bernstein, alongside Kai Sayers, who operates Sanctuary Performing Arts and Community Cafe in Chattanooga, filed a federal lawsuit against several state and local officials, all against the mandate which would require businesses and government facilities open to the public to post a sign if they let transgender people use multi-person bathrooms, locker rooms, or changing rooms. Bernstein says the law is unreasonable and not inclusive.
The first line of my business plan back in 1993 when I opened was, I want to create a gathering place for all of Nashville. And it's things like this that put things in my way that I shouldn't have to deal with.
Bernstein said he's received support from the community about the lawsuit.
It's been amazing to hear friends across the country have seen this article about this court case and found out that my name was attached to it. And for them to reach out and say, thank you, or good job, or brave you. And it's like, brave me. This is nothing compared to what people have to go through every day.
And wants this lawsuit to spark change.
I'm hoping it's over. This bill is ruled unconstitutional and we can move on with our lives.
Nashville District Attorney General Glenn Funk is one of the four defendants listed in the lawsuit. Funk previously released the following statement about the bill on May 24th. I believe every person is welcome and valued in Nashville. Enforcement of transphobic or homophobic laws is contrary to those values. My office will not promote hate. I reached out to Governor Bill Lee's office for a response to this lawsuit, but have yet to hear back. The law will go into effect on July 1st. In Nashville, Alex Corradetti, News 2.